It's January 19th, 2023, 24. I'm still on modified or limited movement, due to the broken ankle, as per board certified surgeon. So, I'm watching this morning, stuck in this position, the sorcery or the television, whatever it is. And it displays, I taped the series of Smithsonian Channel. It's history according to Smithsonian. So I'm watching it. And it seems very football centric or sports centric. It speaks of some battlefield and fight. Apparently, on this Buffalo Bills, it mentions something about Kansas City, or Kansas Pacific Railroad. Again, if I think in God terms, in geography, and not necessarily oceanic, but some form of water involved in parts of this route, tributaries, if nothing else, in the Goot system as opposed to the God system, and not wanting the TV to rot my brain necessarily, because of however things are going. And then I hear of this fight somewhere between Brit they talk of British. I mean, again, none of this history was taught, but yet I'm here. They use the monetary system of General George Washington. It has strategic communications built into its very important legal tender and paper. I'm just stuck here. And I watched Pennsylvania this morning, and it, again, from a conservative perspective, in I'm not sure how to identify myself in this situation. I don't even know I want to put myself in this situation, but yet here I am, having been brought to some state school called Rutgers to meet strangers in some twilight, and then later taken to Florida. And very little recollection of any that went on in Florida. And then taken back to New York, and just again, like I talk about it, like being put out on a game preserve, but not having any like real function necessarily. Just feeling like the entire time I've been here has just been a waste. I mean, lots of really crucial, important meetings and details, but just a complete waste. Like, I was listening, they put out something called a Taylor Thompson, and I'm watching other people just below my age category, and I'm just like in some gaming generation, and I'm just like, oh. Like the word smut and obscenities come to mind, but in a very conservative way. And she talks about her estranged father. And then that thought of that in quiet solitude, especially after I see the incarceration system they built in Pennsylvania about the eyes of God and solitary confinement, which is exactly what this feels like. I don't know who that estranged father is supposed to be. I really, I don't. Then I see They call it a Quaker hat. I've heard the market call it a Stetson. They reference cowboys. In Pennsylvania, they call it Quaker. I guess the locals have many words they use. Never heard of this Pacific, Kansas Pacific. Not sure why New York was brought into that. Not sure. Again, on an Atlantic side, and there being canals and channels systems and whatever, it seems like a really crucial pivotal point, but how to function. I mean, yesterday they put up, they had Gail King and Charles Barkley. He's basketball for sport. And he was talking to Gail King about trying to avoid taxes. I was like, oh, isn't that interesting? And then, I'm just. And now Highmark Stadium's got something going on with Jordan, and this winter, record amount of snow, just to put in the natural wonder world in with me wondering what on earth is going on and how is it like every place I ever should have been, just it's like a, I don't know, feels like it fell off the face of the earth, but here we are. So they had a rule in Pennsylvania, which I had gone to, when I was in, oh, yesterday they also had Nate had up. Tony DeCoppola did a piece about Nate, who's 6'1", and then him next to a blue whale. And then that blue whale next to the Titanic, like the most iconic ship that the locals made a movie about and talked about on this side of the ocean water. And then this new Icons of the Sea for cruise ship. And it really puts in perspective for me, having been born here, but then not getting to where I feel I needed to be. There's. I've never had access to capital, where I could enjoy a luxury liner or go on on a cruise with my children or by myself. I still don't have access to that level of luxury, but others do. And I'm looking at like what is going on, and there's some real serious problems. And so, but I was able to get to the Naval Air Station or the Naval Station by, it used to be Erickson, now it's Floyd Bennett is what they call it. My son was able, I was able to get my son there just recently to go interview with the Sea Cadets, part of the Naval unit. John Glenn actually was in, there was a picture of him in a glass case for I don't know what reason. So like a little piece of, I guess, Ohio in New York, whatever that means, for astronauts and kids that are starting to pick up on some details, for NASA purpose, I suppose, or perhaps my own edification. Since the locals invited me to some comedy club that says Monahan on it. And then I realized later what the CEO of YouTube's name is for a letter missing here or there. But Heraldy being completely different. So that put into context the icons of the sea. And then the kayak that I was able to get my son into the river just recently th with the Sea Cadets. So at least he was able to paddle in the river with his own US Sea Cadets, or at least the class of sea cadets. But again, management being whatever it was that showed up, I don't know that it would be a very good idea because I don't know who they represent. And I don't want my son to get set on the wrong path. So there's that. In the O-N-E and the G-O-D category. So I'm just going to put up what I found about this Pennsylvania. Apparently, they had a Quaker, Will Penn, and he has this very Stetson-looking hat. I think I went to a rooftop. Mark Engels brought me there. Again, the heraldry and the name—like you expect one stealthy, and something else shows up wearing that label. You're like, wait, what? But luckily, there were two witnesses there from two different sections of humanity that got someplace in life, unlike myself. The blacksmith took me there. And then this Mark Engels thing was there with Gotham in New York City. So, but he wasn't like, don't want Roadhouse to get confused. The stealth with the jackets that showed up that night, very tall, very out in the parking lot telling Falco, white Mustang with two black stripes. Not like you might have heard things, but. Like there's that's a like a head thing and you're not supposed to be with her, but it is whatever it is at this point. Apparently there was somebody that came in that built higher and disrespected the Quakers in Pennsylvania. I know I went there, I know what I went there for. Knowing about lambs and mint and whatever else was going on and whatever. Last night I saw on one of the television programs a specific glass, or it wasn't made out of glass, it was made of a different substance, but it was on a show and it was sold in this market in New York for a while back in late 90s. So this is Pennsylvania, according to
High
Smithsonian
in 21st
Channel.
century Philadelphia, a 17th century giant stands guard. Cast in solid bronze by sculptor Alexander Milne Calder, and standing 37 feet high, it's the tallest statue atop any building in the world. But this man wasn't a president or a mythical figure. He was an English Quaker, philosopher, and entrepreneur named William Penn. Penn won his perch atop City Hall by founding Philadelphia and Pennsylvania in 1681, and by guaranteeing those who came to settle here freedom of religion from it.
Interestingly enough, I did hear that too. New York Mets players, their numbers were just retired. I happen to have met both of them in baseball at a charity event I attended with real estate. I think there's photos of us, whatever, but
For many at the time, that was an idea unknown in their native lands. Penn's holy experiment drew thousands of settlers and inspired America's founding fathers a century later as they outlined their new country's constitution. For years, out of respect for Penn, developers in Philadelphia didn't build any structures that stood higher than his statue. At least until 1987, when the spire of a new building called One Liberty Place shot up 397 feet higher than Penn's cap. But soon, Philadelphia sports fans were scratching their heads. After One Liberty Place was completed, none of the city's four professional sports teams won a single championship for years. Locals called it Billy Penn's curse. Luckily, it wasn't to last forever. In 2007, construction workers finishing a new, even taller tower, now home to the cable giant Comcast, fixed a tiny replica of Penn's statue to one of its highest beams. They hoped it would placate Penn's spirit.
Again, this sounds very magnate, something I am not. I'm more like borderline POW MIA is what it feels like, in some hybrid category between God and man, for whatever that means. I'm going to pause this for a second and I'm going to go over to the Buffalo Bills portion, because it seems important, this mention of Kansas Pacific, and this fur trade. So this is the story of Buffalo Bill, according to the Great Plains, on the Smithsonian Channel.
There may be no single image that better captures the timeless spirit of the Great Plains than this. A herd of bison on the move across the prairie. As many as 60 million of these majestic animals, also known as American buffalo, once blanketed the Great Plains. In fact, their range is believed to have stretched all the way from what's now eastern Washington to western New York State. For Plains Indians, bison have long been sacred creatures, in part because of their remarkable size and impressive strength. But they have also been an important source of sustenance. A single bison could provide hunters with up to 400 pounds of meat. It's why for thousands of years, Plains tribes gathered for seasonal bison hunts. One of the places they did it was here, at what's now known as First Peoples Buffalo Jump State Park in Montana. For miles away, hunters from the Blackfeet tribe guided herds of wild bison into a drive lane they had built from piled rocks and brush. It led right up to a cliff. When the cornered animals finally go.
Now, here's a problem. Ben's new girlfriend, who seems nice and wonderful for him, he seems happy. I'm real happy for him. She called herself Blackfoot. So now this concerns me. Not really sure what the crazy donkey did with my children in their absence from my nesting with them. I don't know if they have a nester assigned to them specifically. I don't know who that nester is strategizing with. All of these things are very real concerns of mine based on the situation that I'm trapped in with some blacksmith meeting and a second marriage certificate that means just as little as the first. None of it was as it should have been, especially having calcaneus calculus the way that I do.
They got there, we had no choice but to jump over the edge. Down below, more hunters were ready to finish off the injured animals with clubs, spears, and arrows. Native Americans used just about every part of the bison they killed. Dried meat helped sustain them during the long, cold winters on the plains. Bones became tools, and the animal's skin, clothing, and shelter. The hunting prowess of these tribes enabled them to provide a staggering quantity of pelts to the European and American fur traders, who arrived on the plane starting in the 1700s. The most famous of those traders was a man named John Jacob Astor. In 1828,
they mentioned these traders. That frightens me, knowing there's one General George Washington and one first president George Washington in this system I was born to, and not knowing, is it the Americans and the British fighting? What happened? I mean, they just mentioned someone by the name of Frederick the 10th for the first time ever the other day. Again, I don't know if this has gotten to icons of the sea and now is like really going into dangerous territory. And not knowing, like, really presenting as Jackson on Independence Hall for real. Not necessarily redneck or like red or blue lined, and not having access to any capital from either. So it's really a, like, in research studies they call this a blind. It's a double blind is what it is.
Astor's American Fur Company established a trading post here at Fort Union, near where the Missouri and Yellowstone rivers meet in what's now North Dakota. It became a key hub in a vast network of forts, suppliers, traders, and exporters that stretched across the northern plains. Here at Fort Union, which has since been reconstructed, Astor's men traded with members of the Ojibwe, Blackfeet, Crow, and Cree, among others. They bought as many beaver pelts as they could to ship off to Europe, where they were turned into stylish hats, including top hats, which were the height of fashion at the time. But in the 1830s, the American Fur Company also shipped 25,000 robes made from bison fur out of the Great Plains each year. By the time Astor died in 1848, the great slaughter of the American bison had begun. Over the coming decades, settlers, hunters, and others nearly wiped out this species. In the 1860s, one hunter earned his famous nickname, Buffalo Bill, after claiming to kill more than 4,200 bison at a rate of roughly 8 creatures a day. He was under contract to provide food for workers building the Kansas Pacific Railroad.
Kansas Pacific.
When trains started running across the Great Plains, passengers often stuck their guns out of the windows and fired away on herds of bison as they passed, just for sport. At the end of the century, of the tens of millions of wild bison that covered the plains, only about 1,000 were left.
Now, to be fair and honest, one of the late night shows Linda tapes and watch, and I've just recently been trying to follow some line of reality with the Earthlings or the humans or the New Yorkers or whatever, to like try to just balance myself in like what the heck is going on. Reporting back in a church, it is just, it's precarious at this point. But he had on yesterday, he says, this is not presidential. This is like saying Ron DeSantis is up against Ron DeSantis. It's the same level candidate. I mean, and again, that placates at icon of the sea level, I would assume. Again, I don't have access to capital, never have. Haven't been able to take my kids on a cruise. Haven't gone myself. Not that I wouldn't have loved leisure and travel. But again, it's part of the migration and movement of people that has become a real eyesore, I suppose. And so I made note like of it for my own edification. And I'm going to pause this for a second and go to another important mention. Now, staying with, I don't really know how the Bible is structured. Again, I see words. I know there's land placement elsewhere, and then I see this piece up here, and it says Jordan. It says another northeast winter wallop, Jordan Steely, on heavy snow and freezing temps for this weekend at Orchard Park, New York, from the Weather Channel. And it's Highmark Stadium, which is where these buffaloes are. What that means in the big wide world of things, I don't know. But I was, interestingly enough, on a Zoom with the Zion Episcopal Church, where I am, indoors. It's my local community. It's what's accessible in close proximity. And I guess the room operator did not have on the mute button, and somebody had come in, and I guess they were reading through whatever the text was, and you could hear them say, "It's not the same." Again, I don't know how the diocese works, Bible structure, who gets to publish where. Again, how secular works. These are all things that were not pronounced to me as to how these organizations are in some form of occupation with whatever, and the whatever have constructed themselves or been constructed and then orchestrated in a certain fashion. And who's at the helm? I'm not quite sure. Never have been. Like, they have, again, if we're speaking iconic of the sea, how is the one person standing looking at this gigantic blue whale? I mean, perspective wise, I don't know the name of the gigantic blue whale, so it's a little hard at person level, but I know. Out there's someone at a Titanic level, and then there's somebody at an icon of the sea level. That much I've always understood and respected. I just, how and what is going on, and whatever this game is that they're doing, I'm still not very clear on. I get glimpses through whatever this is, but even the teachings, not through the church. Not through the public schools, not through the private schools. It really was just, it felt like no doors were open and everything was closed. And it's remained that way. And it's just getting worse. And I don't know why. But again, I have special calcaneus calculus. And I know I'm RH sensitive. I already know that at this point. It's *1978, *8378, Nicole Catarusa. It's Earth, Solar System, Milky Way, Universe, Galaxy is broken, and it's Bayside Station, Bayside, New York, 11361.